review of a website that was submitted. This is Black Crystal Enterprises. And on the left-hand side, you'll see the website evaluation report. And on the right-hand side, you'll see blackcrystalenterprises.com. Site grade's obviously pretty low, so I figured we'd go take a look at the developers of the site. The website grade's 6 out of 100. This is, you basically are not really competing online unless you've got a site that's built properly. So websites are built in a series of different layers, one of them being the database, one being your business logic or code, the other being a content management system, another layer of business logic, which gives the website a brain, and lastly is your presentation layer, which is the visually how the website looks. So in this situation, when you have a site that grades this low, 9 times out of 10, this is a site that was either built a long time ago, it was a hand-coded site, which means it's flat, it has no brain, no engine, no CMS or content management system, no database, and so forth. Or there's things that are severely wrong with it. Like I saw one the other day that had a no index, no follow on the whole site, which meant Google can't crawl any of the pages on the entire website. Sometimes it can be a mistake from a developer, but most of the time, if you have a site that grades 6 out of 100, it just hands down has to be replaced. So let's go through and go check out who built the site, because the way that this works is when you have a website built, you can count on the fact that you will probably never receive a website that it grades higher than that person who built it, or performs better than the person who built it. Out of all of our customers, even in our own business, our website grades 99 out of much bigger customers than or bigger size companies than I am. So they can afford to put more resources into their project. So let's go grab, we're going to go grab, the Velocity, which the guys who built the site, guys or gals, and let's go ahead and grade this one. And then I'll pull up our site. There it is. So you can kind of see the difference of what I'm talking about. Our site grades, like I said, 99 out of 100. Our blog grades, 93 out of 100. We have got 3,500 index pages. Optimization, obviously good. All pages, obviously good. This site is only a year old. Backlinks, homepage, social media integration, RSS, conversion forum, and traffic rank is in the top 1% in the world. So you'll kind of see the difference. Now, Velocity, the company that built it, their site grades 1 out of 100. They have no index pages. They have attempted to optimize their site. I'll tell you, it's really, really hard to perform on a website when you optimize a site that's not built properly. No images, no headings, no index pages. They've been online 11 years. Their site expires in 4 months. And no mobile optimization, no social media integration, no RSS, no conversion form, and they have absolutely no traffic. So it kind of just, you know, when you're shopping for a website, it's very, very important that you know who you're dealing with and you know what they're capable of creating. And this is a really easy, cool tool to be able to get just a general idea. Remember, website grader, this is essentially it's an aggregator, which means it doesn't think for itself. It goes out and grabs data from all these different components and it puts it into this aggregated report. So for the average Joe, this is the best tool that you can utilize in order to get an idea of if something is built right or performing or has any traffic or is page ranked and so forth. Now, in a development agency, like in our own company, we use tools that are much, much, much more advanced than those, but it does no good for me to confuse everyone by showing you our sets of tools when they're too complicated for an average website owner who doesn't do this for a living to use on a regular basis. So this is a great tool to kind of get your feet wet with. Now, let's go back to Black Crystal Enterprises. First thing I noticed is their menu bar is in a Flash file up here, which means all of these menu items are unindexable. Also, they don't work. Oh, just a minute ago I clicked on it and none of them worked. Okay, so now they do. All right, so changing the menu headers like this is not a great idea. Also, the sound definitely is something that you want to avoid. So I know the flash file, it's only on this front page. But that, if somebody's at work and they're trying to search and they get sound, whether it's music playing as soon as you get to the side, a video playing on autoplay when you get to the side, or buttons that do clicks and all these things, you want to really, really stay away from those if at all possible. So menus, you never want to have a flash menu, not indexable by Google. I noticed they have another menu down here on the side. So this is what Google is indexing. We're going to go through. We're going to look at the permalinks up here in the top, /index, /contact, /construction, /management. So if you think about this from the company standpoint, there is a series of products and services that you're looking at marketing. But the only things that are being shown to Google is management, customer service, contact, communication, about, let's see, we probably have art.htm and energy.htm. So this is just is not enough information for a permalink structure. Now let's go through here. Right now you have 19 pages on indexed by Google. Think about Google as this huge filing system. So if you want to be found for a particular phrase, like oil and gas, then it's very, very important that you have pages that are titled oil and gas, or oil mineral rights, or whatever the mineral rights for sale, anything like that. You want to make sure that you are optimizing those pages. Otherwise, there's no way Google can place you in the right file drawer to be found. So that'll never really happen. Right now, we'll go through on the left-hand side your metadata. The only information that is being passed through to Google is that this is Black Crystal Enterprises. That's not enough information to be able to get you indexed properly in the right drawer, or to even come close to putting you in front of prospects who are looking for your services. On the site, there are no headings on the entire site, so these are, it's kind of a hand-coded site. Not a lot to it, actually. This is it, plus the entire website was built in tables. So this is something, if you are on Google Chrome, you can just right-click and click Inspect Element. If you're using Firefox, you can download a program called Firebug and right-click, click on Inspect Element, and you can see the actual top layer of code. You can't see server-side code, but it's enough information to get an idea. So here it says no headings found, even though here I see you have an H1 tag. The problem is when you take a header tag, which is very important to Google, and you embed it inside a table, in Google's eyes, tables are very, very frowned upon, not something that it wants. We'll get rid of that. And basically, in a nutshell, this is what we're allowing Google to crawl when we get to the site, which is an empty space. So that's where a lot of these issues are going to come from. No headings. There are headings. I saw the H1 tags, but you can't embed those inside of a table. That's a no-go. Same thing, all of the pages, the only information that is shown to them is Black Crystal Enterprises. Right now, there's no descriptions, no optimization, no headings, no content, and so forth. The domain age is 9 years, 6 months old, so you have an awesome domain name. That is so great that this has that long on the internet. That's a big deal to Google, is how long you've been around. But the domain does expire in 5 months and 1 week, so you are going to want to go call GoDaddy or whoever your domain registrar is and get that updated as quickly as possible. That's very important, because right now in Google's eyes, it looks like the website's going to be closing down in 5 months. While you're on the phone with them, you're also going to want to ask them for a 301 redirect. That's free. They should be setting that up. Anyone that builds websites should know that they've got to have a 301 redirect. That way Google thinks that www.blackcrystalenterprises and Black Crystal Enterprises are the same site, so you get full search engine credit for both. No Google PageRank, no backlinks, which essentially means the site has no testimonials or endorsements. Backlinks are critical to Google taking your pages and putting them towards the top of the list or towards the front of the file drawer, because it wants to know, do other people trust you? So it'll be very important that you have a good backlinking program going on. You have your gen. That's incredibly important for the success of this site. Obviously, with the redesign, that's going to take care of the mobile optimization issues. Right now, there's no social media integration, so the only forum that we're allowing people to contact us is either by phone or by email, which I saw on the site. There's no way that people can subscribe. So if you want to be a leader or a thought leader within your industry, it's very important that you allow people to subscribe via an RSS feed to your website and blog. That way you're the one that's constantly adding new content, new information. You're being educational. If anyone who's in business, if you're not educating your prospects, someone else is. So it's very important that you provide education, and a blog is a great way to do that. And bottom line, kind of it all results in is no traffic, which is why the traffic's in the bottom 67 percentile, which is very, very low. So not as low as not ranked, which we do see a lot. But this is a really good case to be able to get this site revamped up and running. Personally, I think that this site, you could get into one of our small business solutions for $300 and have us transfer your content. The site is so small and there's really not much to it that I don't think you need to invest a ton of money in some big web redesign. I think if you went with the CI Website Builder solution, hopefully solution number three, which includes the social media publishing and your off-page, on and off-page optimization, that's going to put you in a better position. You'll have a website, you'll have an integrated blog, you'll have integrated social media publishing, you'll have a backlinking program going on, and you're talking about a $300 investment. So it's too easy to get this kind of a website into the right technology so it can actually start playing a marketing role within the business. And when you look at cost, truly your costs are the cost of not doing it correctly, the lost opportunity cost. So I hope this was helpful. If you're just watching this for the first time and you have a website that you would like us to review, please don't hesitate to go to ciwebsitebuilder.com/review and submit your information. We'd be happy to do that for you. Thanks again. I look forward to talking with you over at Black Crystal Enterprises, and I appreciate your time today.